your boat gently down the stream. Ain't nobody in the club feeling like me. Plus, I got a click of gorillas and black tees. Make the whole club clap like it's some kind of disease. Put in here, let me get that
hand clap. Lisa, the previous owner, reached out to me this past year and just was like, you know, I've had my time. Is this something that you would be interested in? You know, you love the kids more than anything. Do you want it?
That's right. After close to 40 years teaching dance, Lisa Friend was ready to sell the Performing Arts Center in Boardman and move on to a different career. Her former student and instructor, Mallory Miller, was there to pick up the phone.
I like immediately called my mom. I was like, you're never gonna believe this. And she's like, oh my God, this is what you've wanted your whole life. Uh-huh. She's like, we have to start making plans now.
The answer was a resounding yes. And it turns out, even though Mallory was in Columbus and pretty young, she was planning for this day for quite a while.
I mean, I was working sometimes 19-hour days because I knew that in the end, this is where I was gonna be. And I needed to financially set myself up for success before I got here.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone was always like, why aren't you teaching in Columbus? You know, you love dance. Why don't you just find a studio? Because this is my home. And that's what I want to pour myself into, is where I feel that my love is.
The next step was to tell the students.
One day when we were coming into dance, Miss Lisa, she had an envelope and we opened it and she told us that she was leaving and Mallory was coming. I was happy that she was coming back because I really missed her when she left. But I was also sad that Miss Lisa was leaving.
So the transition was complete, less than a month before a national competition, but the girls didn't miss a beat.
They work well together, and a lot of these kids spend more time here at the studio than they do at home. Between school and dance and home, they're here more.
It's like a way to like express yourself without like telling people. Mm-hmm. You can just like dance through it.
What separates us would be my staff, 100%. I mean, you can't find another studio in this area that has a Broadway trained employee that is on their staff.
Miss Mallory says she's not going to change much, maybe just a few advancements here and there. But her friends in Columbus have noticed one thing that's changed, her all-around disposition.
And I would call them when I'd come here and be like, hey, you know, I made it, I'm safe. And they were like, your voice and your attitude is a whole 180 when you're in Youngstown. They're like, you can hear the happiness come out of you.
Mm-hmm.
And the dancers are happy too, from the little ones. To the big ones.
Creates a tighter bond. I think the studio gives life lessons to girls that they can carry outside of here, outside of dance. Yeah, I think it's a good place for anybody.
Oh, and one more change. Miss Mallory, the student, is no longer.
Do you ever walk by your picture and
gasp?
Yeah. Maybe not gas, but just step out of yourself and be like, here I am.
I mean, to this day, I feel like I'm in this fog. Like, I'm just like, how is it that it's mine? Like, it's mine.
I look up to her. I look up to what she was when she was a dancer here at the studio. And I'm glad to have been carrying on the legacy of her being a student here and me now a graduating student here.
It's just pure happiness. Like, I can't even... It's mine because it's the kids. It's just what, I'm doing this for them. And I don't know, it just feels surreal. It's very surreal.